This is the Tan Talk Radio Network.
It's Monday! Do you need some Monday motivation? The Shop Local for Good News team is here. I'm Karina Morrison, and we're bringing you the good news stories of our neighbors doing good in our neighborhoods.
You can find us on Facebook Live on the Shop Local for Good page, and we're looking forward to your calls.
Let's get this Shop Local for Good News conversation started, shall we? Good morning, Tampa Bay. Can you hear me? Ed, can you hear me? I can't hear myself. All right. We are the Shop Local for Good News show, and I'm having a little technical difficulties. I didn't drink my coffee this morning. Uh-oh. Okay. This is a Shop Local for Good News show, and we are on air every Monday morning from 8 a.m. to 9 a.m. We have a very special guest today. Her name is Fair Montecalvo. She is the founder and CEO of the Rap Stars Dream Team. And full disclosure, I'm part of her team, and I'm very honored to be part of her team. It's very motivational, and she has a very powerful personal story that I want her to share. First of all, I just want to get a little bit of announcements done because we want people to come out this Friday. This Friday is Blast Friday in downtown Clearwater, and it's from 6 p.m. to 10 p.m. We're going to have the Fix out there. We are going to be, Shop Local for Good's going to be rocking the 600 block of Cleveland. We've got food trucks and great shopping and lots of fun. I think we have, at last call, we had two bands, and we're possibly going to have three on the 600 block. So we are seriously going to be rocking the 600 block. And then Saturday, February 23rd, is the Saturday Community Market, where we are still looking for local entrepreneurs and to be out there from 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. So you can come out and shop. We are the only indoor-outdoor market in downtown Clearwater. That is at 628 Cleveland Street. The Market Space for Good is also open Tuesday through Sunday from 11 a.m. to 6 p.m. at 628 Cleveland Street in the Station Square Creative Suites. Suite 11. So you just walk in the front door and come around the back. Take a left and then walk straight back. You'll hear my radio. And if I hear the door open, I usually peek out the door because it's a really cool office. There's a bunch of office suites and we're the only retail shop in there, sort of by the back, by the kitchen. So you have to go on a shopping adventure to find us. Awesome. You'll see the sign on the sidewalk and then you can come in. But thank you for joining us today.
Thank you for having me. I'm so honored to be here.
You're welcome. Okay. I do want to get into your story because you'll be amazed how fast an hour goes by. Now, you had found yourself in a very challenging position before you have gotten to where you are today. And a lot of people look at people who have had success and they think that it was overnight. Or they think that, oh, she must have had a whole bunch of money, you know, to invest in and that kind of thing. Or you're so brave. I could never be that brave, that kind of thing. But you had found yourself in a situation where you just jumped, like Steve Harvey says.
Absolutely. My story was anything but right. A success story to begin with. I was a single mother of four. To say I was broke and broken is an understatement. I might even get teary-eyed.
Right. I had found
myself in just a really bad predicament. And I started just praying for something, some kind of change. And lo and behold, God presented me with an opportunity. And I was scared. I absolutely was scared. I'm human. So I had my fears, just as everyone does. But I, like I said, I was at such a point where something had to change. So for me, it was like, what I've been doing all these years isn't working. Therefore, I have to do something differently. So I jumped, afraid and all.
Right. Well, and you were working 2 to 3 jobs and still not making it.
Exactly. I was working full-time as a bartender, part-time for a doctor's organization doing community outreach, and still found myself living under paycheck to paycheck. I wasn't even paycheck to paycheck, you know?
Right. There's a lot of people finding themselves in that situation.
Absolutely.
And so this opportunity that you found, it excited you because, when we met first at the women's conference, I could tell that you just truly care about other people and helping other people, and even helping them find ways to be more healthy.
Absolutely.
So this opportunity that you came across was a good fit for you because it enabled you to also help people.
It lined right up with all my passions.
Right.
I love helping people. I have degrees in healthcare, so it was also health and wellness related. So everything lined up perfectly. And it was just like I said, it was a godsend.
That's fine. That's amazing.
Yeah.
Now, what I do want people to understand too is it's huge. Been with the company for 5 years?
Five and a half. July will be 6 years.
Five and a half.
Yeah.
And you're up pretty high on the ranking scale.
Yes.
I'm not sure how people would. So how would you describe it? So like for me, I'm a distributor.
Correct.
So, and then you move up when you have other people underneath you.
Yes.
Right.
As your business starts to grow, you move up in the ranks. So right. There's 8 ranks in the company and I'm at the 7th rank.
That's exciting.
Yes, very.
Okay. Now, it took you a lot of work.
Absolutely.
People need to understand that too.
Absolutely.
It's not just a snap and you get up there.
No. My business did grow quickly, but right. I credit that to the hard work of myself as well as my other teammates.
Right.
There was probably it was a good 3-year period where sacrifice was absolutely a daily thing.
And that's with any small business.
Absolutely.
Because I'm a business owner and I was looking up some statistics with the Labor Bureau, and I'm going to flip them around because the word failure to me, I've lost a lot of money testing things different. I'm a tester. I'm an outside the box thinker. I like to try things. And what I try to explain to people too is I failed a lot, but I consider them lessons.
Absolutely.
And I'm not a classroom girl. So instead of paying to sit in a classroom, you know, and get a piece of paper that says I know what I'm doing, I actually test things and invest in them as an entrepreneur. And I might not have the piece of paper. I could make a piece of paper for somebody. however, I've got the grassroots experience, probably the those classroom people might not have.
Right.
And then what's a lot of people don't understand too, and you'll get this right away, I'm pretty sure. The more you push yourself, the less afraid you become.
Absolutely.
The less afraid of anything.
Absolutely.
I mean, public speaking, the first time I went public speaking, I could still flash back and feel my knees weak. I was speaking at it was the school board meeting. And of course, in Florida, all government meetings are on video.
Right.
And I am so hard on myself anyway, to begin with. I could hear my voice shaking. I knew my knees were shaking and it was only 3 minutes.
Yeah.
But then more and more and more. And I was speaking to crowds of over 1,000.
Right.
But it takes practice. You got to practice being afraid.
And your confidence will grow the more you do it.
Right.
Absolutely.
And you might screw up, but then how many people saw me do that and was like, wow, if Karina will do that, maybe I can.
Exactly.
And I like inspiring people.
Absolutely.
Because then you build a team of people that are inspired around you. And that's another thing. Surround yourself with like-minded people.
Absolutely.
Now, what are some of the fears that you get when you're talking to people about potentially growing with your team or getting involved?
The most common fears are other people's opinions.
Right.
The fear of failure. The fear of investing too much time and money and not, basically goes along with the fear of failure, just not reaping the rewards at the end of it. Right. But I truly believe people's number one fear is other people's opinions.
Isn't that sad?
It breaks my heart.
It does.
Because other people's opinions don't pay your bills.
No. And they shouldn't affect your actions either.
Right, right.
You got to believe in yourself.
Right. And honestly, for me, I had other people's opinions, and I have a big fear of rejection. That's probably my biggest thing, is I want everybody to like me,
right?
Which is ridiculous because I'm a grown woman and who cares? But I do, I have this fear of rejection. And so that for me was really hard, because those opinions meant they were rejecting what I was doing.
Right.
But as I started growing and building that confidence, and the more I did it and the more confident I got and the more successful I became, a lot of those opinions started changing. And right. a lot of those haters or people whose opinions were loud are now either on my team. They might be my customer.
Right.
Or they simply, I ran into a friend the other night at a restaurant who I haven't talked to in years. And he simply said, I am so proud of you. You
nice.
Had so many people saying you couldn't. And here you are, you did.
See, I have a feeling you're a lot like me. When people tell me I can't do something, I'm like, oh, watch me.
Exactly. I'm going to do it tenfold.
Yeah. Okay, you just go ahead and sit on back.
Exactly.
And that's okay, too. What I want people to understand is other people's opinions of you really don't matter. And if they come at you with a negative opinion, you just let it roll off your back.
It's usually a reflection of themselves too. If they think
they're
that
afraid.
You can't, it's because deep down they believe that they couldn't, you know, which is sad, but it's true.
Right. Well, and here's what you do. You don't take it personally, and you say, well, it's probably not for you then.
Exactly.
And then it gets them thinking, hey, wait, what?
Right.
Like, wait, why isn't it for me?
Right.
So now, another reason why, how I got involved with It Works is because I'm huge into homeopathy, and
absolutely,
I understand that I'd much rather eat right and do nutrition-based, especially the plant-based products,
yes,
than take a pharmaceutical.
Right.
So anyway, around that, I can get around that. And our mutual friend, Gabby, mm-hmm. I've known her a couple of years through my company. And she truly and honestly cared enough to realize that I had pushed myself to exhaustion from a festival that I was managing. And she just, I'm over here if you need me. You know, she wasn't pushy about it.
Right.
And then I'm like, okay, the coffee. I'll try the coffee. And then I've gotten into the other products that they're just phenomenal.
Absolutely.
Now, how I operate is I like to observe, because I've been in other direct sales companies that the corporate culture to me was not cool. You know, they're very pushy. Just get people under you. Don't build relationships. And so I was observing a lot. And I wanted to make sure that the products worked for me.
Right.
Because if I'm going to recommend something, it's going to be something I believe in.
Absolutely.
And everything that I've done with It Works products are just top notch too.
I absolutely love them.
Yeah.
And I love that you brought up the culture, because I had been to every home party. I had seen other opportunities out there, and it just wasn't a fit for me. Not that it's not okay for other people, but for me. And when I found It Works and the culture and the whole thing, like I said, just lined right up with my passions and who I am as a person. And the culture is second to none. I mean, they are truly a company of, yeah, absolutely. We not all the way from our corporate team, all the way, you know, our CEO, all the way down. Everybody wants to help other people succeed. It's amazing.
It is. And your husband's on your team too. You got to retire him.
He is. He's a rock star too.
That's so awesome.
Yeah.
So it's a family business.
Absolutely. We've both been doing it full time since, well, he came home from his job in June of 2015. So we've both been full time almost 4 years now with the company.
So as a single mom, you jumped all in.
I did. I was single. We were dating. I was dating my now husband.
Yeah.
But I jumped all in, and even he was like, I'm not sure. He wasn't super, he was still supportive, because he's supportive of me.
Right.
But he was still skeptical as to how far we could take it or what we could actually do with it. So it was pretty fun to watch him change from skeptical to he is my number one fan.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
I saw a video that he did that was talking about that.
Absolutely.
It was very powerful.
Yeah.
So, and you have to understand that your family and friends don't necessarily have to be your customers.
Absolutely not.
No.
Most of my team has been grown from complete strangers. Yeah. Most.
I was, I stopped into the Whiskey Depot last night on my way back from St. Petersburg. It's a place that I know the owners, and I have an idea for the new Hydrate product. So any bartenders out there need to contact Fair or me, because that Hydrate product, I see, because of my bartending past, I understand that the reason why you feel like crap the next morning is because you're dehydrated.
Exactly.
And if you drink the garbage that they have, you know, the Gatorade, whatever, it's full of sugar.
Absolutely.
And that Hydrate has all the good stuff.
Electrolytes.
The electrolytes. You drink one of those before you go to bed or before you leave the bar, preferably.
Right.
And then one in the morning and you're good to go. Yeah. Or if you're working out, it'll help you recover.
Absolutely.
That product, I'm really excited about.
I'm super excited. Honestly, dehydration is something that so many people suffer from and they don't even know it.
Exactly.
And so I feel like it could help everyone in any circumstance, be it a hangover or be it just a person tired. Who doesn't drink enough water, tired. Exactly. Yeah. So I'm super excited about that product.
Yeah. A lot of people don't realize that their exhaustion and their tiredness and whatever is health related.
Absolutely.
It's, you're not drinking enough water, people.
Absolutely.
And then, you know, a lot of people just don't like the taste of water or what, and water doesn't have all the electrolytes in it that you need.
Right.
Another thing that I really love about the It Works opportunity is you actually have two options. You can buy retail and there's no commitment at all.
Right.
Or you can save, what, it's 40%?
40% off the retail cost.
For a loyal customer, and the loyal customer ranking is like easy.
It's so awesome. The program is super easy.
Yeah. And not much of an investment. You could try a product. One product each month for 3 months, then you're a loyal customer for life.
Absolutely.
Wow.
Yeah. It really is the best wholesale program. You know, I'm a member of Costco and Sam's and all that, and you pay a yearly fee. With It Works, they waive the yearly fee as long as you just try at least one product for 3 consecutive months, and you save so much. You basically get 3 products for the price of one if you went the retail route.
Right.
So it's an awesome program.
And there's so many cool things to try.
Absolutely. We have over 45 products now, I believe.
Nice.
Yeah.
I really like the new you.
That's one of my husband's favorites too. He loves it.
I can tell when I'm not taking it.
His favorite thing about that is his sleep has improved.
Yes, ma'am. Yeah. That's what I can tell when I don't take it.
He loves it. For me, the collagen. Yeah, the collagen has helped my sleep immensely.
I take them both. Because much like you, I wasn't a single mom, but I chose to homeschool. So in order to do that, I had to be home with the kids while the husband was at work.
Right.
And there was, you know, no school to send them to because I was a teacher.
Right.
That's how I'm using my college degree. And so I worked overnight shifts for a good decade.
Oh, my goodness.
And then would come home, take a nap, and then the kids would wake up. So I got used to napping.
Right.
And if you do that for 10 years,
your
body's like,
yeah,
I don't need to sleep at night.
Yeah.
And so the collagen and the new you are just, they're phenomenal. And they're all plant-based, y'all.
Right. They're amazing.
Plus my skin is very soft.
I'm loving what the collagen's done for my skin. Cleared up so much.
Yeah.
My husband had what's called sleep shift disorder because he worked in the poker industry for all those years. And he worked the graveyard. He worked from 7 p.m. to 3 a.m. So he would come home and same thing. It would be a nap. He never slept real hours.
Right.
So he'd nap from, you know, 4 a.m. to 7 a.m. when my alarm would go off to get the kids up to school.
Yep.
And then he would be awake. It was just like so, his sleep was so off. And so he has really, it took him a while to get on a good regimen, but with the products, he swears his sleep, I mean, I know because I sleep next to him and he sleeps good.
Well, when you wake up before your alarm goes off, you know that you've rested.
Right.
And that's how I know I've rested.
Yeah.
Then you have the keto coffee and you're good to go.
I got mine right here.
There you go. I was also talking to her about the keto coffee and she's really interested in that. Now, I'm actually, I don't even follow the keto diet and I was drinking it for the mental clarity that I get from the grass-fed butter and the MCT oil, and it has collagen in it as well.
Absolutely.
And then it also does, you know, it fills you up.
Right.
So sometimes I forget to eat, which isn't healthy. So, but it does curb your appetite.
Right. Well, when you're on the keto diet, forgetting to eat is called intermittent fasting, which is actually good for the lifestyle. So,
Okay. See, I told you I wasn't on the diet.
Yeah. People always say it's not healthy to skip a meal, but actually with intermittent fasting, it is healthy to skip a meal. So,
cool. I learned something new.
The MCT oil, the grass-fed butter will absolutely fill you up and keep you full for hours. I usually don't eat lunch till, 1, 2 p.m. after drinking my coffee at 7 a.m. So, yeah.
All I know is that my friend Gabby had to buy me a belt for Christmas because my pants kept falling down in my belt loop holes. I ran out of holes.
Congratulations. That's You're welcome.
And I feel a lot better.
Absolutely.
Too. So what would your, there is a special going on that's like insane. Mm-hmm. For $20. You get over $100 worth of product to try or to resell.
Absolutely.
And that's going on until the end of February.
February 28th, yes.
Okay.
So that's for a distributor. That's different than our customer program. If someone decides they want to do the business, work the business alongside us, it's $20 for the kit. And you get, I think the one of the kits, there's four options. One of them has over $130 worth of product.
Yeah, I saw that.
For $20.
That's a massive sample kit, I think.
It's amazing.
And then they have the keto. I like that you have options.
Exactly.
There's four options.
Yes.
That is cool. So if you're a keto coffee person and that you want that to be your focus, you don't have to get all the other
products,
goodies.
Right, right. You can just get the keto coffee.
And then they have a variety pack if you want to try something of everything.
Which has been my recommendation for all the new distributors is to get the variety pack. Try a little bit of everything. Like you said, it's easy to share a product when you love it.
Exactly.
I've never done sales in my lifetime. So for me, when I joined, it was like, how do I sell things? I don't. I just share what I love and what I use.
There
so the sample pack's great for that.
Oh, cool.
Yeah.
So what are your feedback that you're getting? What do you tell people when they're like, okay, what if I'm not good enough? What would you say to them?
Well, first of all, I believe everyone is good enough because I believe we're all made for more. But it is a matter of growing your confidence, like we said. Something that you've never done before isn't going to come naturally. Just like when I started running, I'm not a runner. I didn't have a runner's physique. I didn't have a runner's lung capacity. So when I started running, I had to train. I had to get good at running.
Right.
And there's no different when you become a business owner is that if you've never, I was an employee my whole life. I had an employee mindset.
Right.
So when I became a business owner, it's retraining your brain to be open-minded, be willing to learn, be coachable. It's so important to be coachable because if you're seeing someone who's had success, you want to emulate what they've done.
Right.
So don't try to reinvent the wheel, but just, know that your confidence will come in time. All your fears are natural. They're not true. Fear is a lie.
Right.
But you can overcome it. You just have to be willing to be open-minded, coachable, and come along for the ride. Take time. Learn. I always tell people, you're not expected to know everything tomorrow.
Right.
Learn while you earn. I'll help you make some money. So a good, part-time income in the meantime. And as you grow, your confidence will grow and you can talk about the business just as good as I can,
Right. Well, and another thing I loved about being on your team too, you offer a lot of training.
I do.
I really love that newbie group, by the way.
Thank you.
With the videos that are broken down and it's bite size.
Yes.
Because that's another thing that people are like, I don't have time.
Right.
And what you have to understand as an entrepreneur, you have time.
You have to make the time.
Yes. You have time. If you want to be successful, not everybody has to do this, but it works.
Right.
You can just be, you can be a customer.
Right.
Feel lots better.
Right.
But it is exciting and it is a phenomenal product too. Make you feel good, feel much better, feel healthier. How many moms out there are so tired by the time they get home that dinner is calling up a pizza place?
Right.
How much money?
I'm guilty in the past.
Oh no, I still do it on occasion.
I was going to say,
Now when I order pizza, my family, unfortunately, each of them have a different pizza they want.
Oh,
so it's like $60.
Right.
Meanwhile, I could have made dinner that everybody could eat, that would cost under $10.
Right.
So it's an exchange of energy and time and where you put your focus.
Absolutely.
Now, and it is a mental mindset, just like you said. And I do believe that a lot of people's fear comes from not understanding and getting into the situation and them getting overwhelmed, like, oh, wow, it's on me, personal responsibility.
Right.
So it's not a boss that you're reporting to.
Right.
You're reporting to yourself.
I believe that's probably the hardest part of entrepreneurship is it's 100% self-motivation. Nobody comes to my house and wakes me up in the morning and tells me to get to work. There's no time clock for me to punch into. So it is 100% motivation. We are all capable. But again, like we said, it's a matter of making the time and making it a priority. And I was at a point in my life 5.5 years ago where, like I said, I knew something had to change. So I was willing to take any extra time I had and pour it into this business.
Right. Now, with Shop Local for Good, I'm spending, there's been weeks where I go 7 days a week, 20-hour days. Whew. And, well, especially before an event.
Right.
And, you know, that's the kind of commitment I've chosen to do because my passion and my mission, you know, to connect the community stronger.
Right.
And here's the thing, but yet I can still talk to my friends or when I'm out, but Gabby does the same thing as I do. We don't know strangers.
Absolutely not.
So, oh my gosh, we were out the other night and we're like, hey, by the way, they've got this hydrate thing. And, you know, and it's just so easy to talk about because it's something that you know will help people.
Right.
And it's, so you're not really selling them. You're saying, I've got this idea that I want to bounce off of you. And it truly is an idea.
Right.
My idea would be to connect with the bartenders.
Right.
Some other people might be involved in the gym.
Right.
I don't have a gym.
Right.
So, you know, and that's where you could be creative and flexible.
Absolutely.
With the products and not necessarily have to just beat people over the head with it.
Absolutely not.
In fact, that annoys me yes. when you do that on social media. Don't do it.
That drives me crazy.
Well, it's about building relationships too.
Absolutely.
If you're not building a relationship with somebody, if you only see them as a dollar sign, that will not get you success.
No.
And it makes you feel yucky inside. At least it does me.
Right.
Because people aren't, that's not what this planet's about.
Right. No, I truly believe the more you help people, the more you help yourself. It's just it's the circle of life. It's how it goes. You know, we're blessed to be a blessing to others. And the more you help other people, the more you will reap the rewards of it.
Well, and just on a personal note, mm-hmm. I was dealing with something that you wrote hit me hard. For many years, I was working in the corporate world. Mm-hmm. And I was, I told you I don't like pills. I was on a pharmaceutical mm-hmm. to help me with depression. Mm-hmm. And I found that we actually lost our insurance and I was on the highest dose there was. Mm. So it wasn't cheap.
Right.
And it was going to be around $1,000 a month for me to be on this goodness. Medication. And I'm like, nope. Well, not wait, $1,000 for the insurance and then $1,000 copay.
Oh my goodness.
So it was going to be $2,000. I'm like, I feel much better now.
Right.
Now. But it did take me a while. And what I found is when my family calls me a serial volunteer, I found that I replaced that little pill.
Uh-huh.
Actually, it was 3 pills. Those pills with volunteering in my community and giving back.
Absolutely.
And that is where I found my happy.
It fills your cup up.
Yeah.
Yeah. I'm the same way. That's my mentality is the more I help people, the happier that fills my cup up.
Yep.
My spiritual cup, all of it. It just makes me so happy to see other people doing well and, and whatever they need. If I can help, I will absolutely do it.
And I got that about you too. So, and that's a part of the culture that I love about it works too. All the way from the CEO down.
Mm-hmm. We're all about giving back.
I was observing. Yes. I've been observing for a few months and you can tell it's not fake.
No, it's genuine.
Yeah. And there was a story about the CEO running into somebody from the year before that he remembered. And those conferences are packed.
Yeah.
How many people do you think were there?
There are usually, we do it at Amalie Arena, so there's usually like 20 to 30,000.
Wow.
Yeah.
And he remembered somebody from the year before.
My husband overheard him having a conversation with a gentleman who didn't appear to be of a higher rank, so probably didn't have a personal relationship with the CEO.
Right.
But the CEO has such a good, he loves people. And he said to the man, "Oh, glad to see you feeling better this year." And my husband was like, "How in the world did he remember that that man didn't feel well last year?" And I was like, "Because he's a real person who really cares about people."
That is cool.
It's impressive. Yeah.
Yeah. That's neat.
Yeah.
And then what I like too is the company's debt free.
Mm-hmm.
So they're not going to get underwater and then nobody has any product and then you have no business.
Right.
Because that is a fear too. When you're working direct sales, you are an entrepreneur because you get the products and then, you know, you can sell the products.
Right.
But you are relying on that company to be stable.
Correct.
And I'm very impressed with the stability of it works.
Me too. I've seen other direct sales companies go out of business, file bankruptcy and go out of business. And what happens is the distributors, the entrepreneurs under that company don't get their commission check.
Right.
That would be devastating for someone like myself, who me and my husband do this full time. It is our full time income, right. You know? And so to know that our company is debt, our corporate team is debt free is a huge, huge weight off the world, you know, weight off my shoulders, knowing that I'm going to get paid.
That's a good thing.
And absolutely.
They have some massive bonuses. Wow.
Absolutely. They're the most giving team ever too. And it's always, I don't even know how they do it sometimes, but I'm like, thank you, Lord. Right. I'm in the right place at the right time.
Well, I like it because they're reinvesting in you.
Yes.
Us. They're exactly. reinvesting in us.
We're the hands and feet of It Works Global. And so I believe that they treat their distributors right because they don't pay for advertising. We are their advertisement. So treat your advertisement right and they will advertise.
Exactly. I'm liking that philosophy.
Yeah.
It's a smart philosophy.
Absolutely.
Well, just like if you're running a company anywhere, if your employees are happy, they're your best ambassadors.
Right. Exactly.
Fantastic. I don't know. I've got a serial volunteer sitting in the corner. She volunteers at the Market Space for Good 6 days a week. Love that kid.
That's awesome.
Well, we are a family-owned business.
Yeah.
So, and a lot of people don't, this is something that I want to go over too. So you're going to have to invest time.
Mm-hmm.
It depends on how big you want to grow.
Right.
You can be part of the, and a lot of direct salespeople, they just want a couple hundred extra a month. Or even enough just to cover the products that you want to buy.
That's okay too. Yeah.
That's fantastic.
Absolutely.
Then you're more healthy and then you're part of a team. It's like a family, really.
Absolutely.
And then you've got the people that will do that for a few years and then bam.
Right.
They're like, "Hey, wait, I'm getting really good at this."
Right.
And then they'll jump.
Right. Seeing the vision.
Yeah.
Absolutely. And it's totally okay when people join me. If they don't want to move fast, that's totally fine. Use the products, get healthy, get comfortable talking about them, and we'll
people
see what happens.
People will notice around you
absolutely.
Too.
That, yeah. I mean, honestly, that was me, is that I didn't, even though I wanted and needed a change, I didn't know. I believed the company, but I didn't know that I actually could do it.
Right.
But the more I learned, the more I invested, the more sacrifices I made to put towards my business, sure enough, the more I grew.
Right. Well, I mean, you have that inner energy too, and the positivity that comes from being a part of a positive team.
Right.
It just, when you're walking through the store or when you're at the bank, people notice.
Right.
They'll notice.
That confidence is there.
Yeah.
And it grows over time. But I do believe you mentioned being surrounded by like-minded people. That is 100% true. Because if you're around people telling you you can't, you're going to start to believe that you can't. Right. But if you surround yourself by people who are constantly telling you, you can, you will, you've got this, I believe in you. It's amazing, the mentality, and you will start to, I can, and I will.
Right.
You know,
there was, I love the inspirational videos. There was, I think I shared it on my wall, but he was talking about looking at yourself So I'm your friend and you start getting down on yourself. And as your friend, I'm like, shut up.
Right.
You're awesome. And he's like, why don't you do that for yourself?
Right.
So you turn it around on, you know, if you're that type of person that's always telling your friends to stop beating up on your friend, you know,
right.
Stop beating up on yourself. You need to turn that advice in on yourself.
Self-love.
Yeah. It's very important.
Absolutely.
To believe that you can make things happen.
Absolutely. And that's another thing, that it's just a fear.
Yeah.
That little voice telling you you can't. It's just an insecurity and a fear, and it's not real.
And you could change that mindset.
Absolutely.
There's actually been studies mentioning positive affirmations to yourself, directing mm-hmm. them mm-hmm. and meaning it.
Right.
What is it? 30 days. Just doing that for 30 days can actually rewire your brain.
Right.
Like scientifically rewire your brain.
Absolutely.
So sometimes the fears are a conditioning mm-hmm. from, you know, yes. what you've dealt with.
Right.
Like you, I'm a people pleaser.
Right.
I want to please people, and a perfectionist too. All kinds of peas going on there.
Me too. That's why we like each other.
Yes. So, I'm just going through and trying to let people know that when I was in the beginning 20 years ago and I spoke at that school board meeting, mm-hmm. I was scared out of my mind.
Right.
The only public speaking that I had was at my Comp 2 class to get my grade in college, right. You know, but I just kept going and kept at it. And whenever you start any kind of business or entrepreneur, you have to keep going. Mm-hmm. Hashtag don't quit.
Exactly.
And you know, people, once again, if you're telling yourself that you're good and you can make it, and you still have the people around you, it's really okay to walk away from the negativity.
You have to.
You can't feel guilty about friends who aren't supporting you.
You have to. And your friend group will change. Yeah. Your circle of friends will change. There might even be family members that you can still love them.
Right.
But you don't have to listen to their negativity.
Right.
And in the beginning, I did lose some friends, and that was okay. I still love them and I'm still cheering for them.
Right.
But we don't have to be around each other all the time, you know?
Right. So that's pretty amazing. Now, okay. So you may be interested in investing a little bit more. You know, if you're going in for the $20, mm-hmm. You do get some products so that you can try them all. Or if you're wanting to do one route over the other, I like the flexibility.
Right.
That ends at the end of February. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Okay. And they could go to Rapstar's Dream Team. That's a Facebook page.
My Facebook page is Rapstar's Dream Team.
Okay.
Yep.
And you've got ways to connect with you for that promo code. It's a promo code. So.
It is. They have to get it directly from me or one of my teammates. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
So that's the distributor.
Yes.
And is there a minimum that they would have to order each month to stay a distributor?
What I love about It Works is we have two options. Yes, you can order your own products each month. And if you choose to go that route, it's about $80 a month.
Okay.
Include tax and shipping into that. We do have a website fee of $20 a month. So include all that. It's about $120 a month. Now, when I started, that was the only option. And I was scared of that because
yes, that's a bill.
I was broke.
Right.
And I had just joined. At that point, it was $99 to join. So I just paid that. And I was finding out 30 days later, I was going to get hit with another $120. I was really, really scared. But the way that my enroller told me was, you can sell the product in your kit and run this business completely free. And so that helped me. Okay. If I could sell the products and just completely keep running it for free, well, then I started loving the products. So what I started doing was putting it half and half. I'd get half of the products to sell, half to keep in my household. So
smart.
Smart. I made it work. But now we have actually got a route where you can run your business completely 100% free, which is your customers. As long as you're over $150 in sales each month, you're good to go.
Nice.
You don't have to order your own product, which I still recommend. Like we said, why would you not want to?
Yes. Why would you not want the keto coffee right. and the hydrate?
Why would you not want some healthy products in your household?
Right.
So,
well, once again, we go back to that's going to save you money.
Right.
You're going to feel better.
Right.
Yeah. people also need to get that into their mindset too. It's where you invest your money.
Absolutely. If you're buying a bunch of pop or soda every day, I forget right. We're in Florida. Y'all say soda from the North originally.
Yeah.
Y'all buy a bunch of soda every day or sweet tea or whatever your guilty pleasure is. If you start putting the proper nutrients in your body, you'd be shocked how many of those cravings will go away naturally.
Oh, absolutely.
Yeah.
Yes. Cause sugar was my thing.
Right. Sugar's addictive and it's expensive.
Yes.
You know, people go to those coffee shops. I won't name names, but those coffee shops and spend $6-7 a day on a coffee. Well, mine's healthy and it's only $3 a day, you know?
Wow. That's, and you can make it at home so you don't have to go through the drive through.
Right. And there's no sugar in it.
and it's got the good grass fed butter.
Right.
And it's non-GMO.
Right.
Wow.
Yeah.
Who wouldn't? And then you can, if you want, add the dark chocolate greens.
That's what I have in mind right now. It's so delicious.
I like that product because it alkalizes you. It's just so, it's like all your fruits and veggies in a cup. I was reading
exactly
the ingredients to my dad and my grandmother the other day, and I kept reading and reading.
Yeah.
Yeah. And they're like, all of that is in my coffee? I said, yes, it is.
Yeah. It's incredible. And you really will get over those other cravings. You know, you'd be surprised. So many people reach out to me and say, I drink X amount of soda a day. And I'm like, okay, let's start working on cutting back.
Right.
Adding in water, adding in some of my products. And before you know it, you know, as long as they're willing to go through the crash, the initial
right.
cravings and stuff like that, they'll get through it.
And they're saving money.
And once their body is has the proper nutrients, they won't crave it anymore. It's a matter of getting there.
Right. Well, and they're saving money.
Absolutely.
So you put that, every time you do this, you put that extra $3 aside and you can start your own business.
There you go. It's a great way to look at it. Yeah.
Yeah. In less than a week.
Right.
7 days times three.
Right.
Hey, that's cool.
That's awesome.
I like math. I'm a geek. So just a couple of statistics because I like statistics too. Mm-hmm. So what people really should know is that these are from the U.S. Bureau of Labor Statistics. 50% of small businesses fail in the fifth year.
Wow.
Yeah. And I think a lot of that has to do with not being, well, 80%. Let's give a positive one. 80% make it past their first year, but that means 20% fail. And I think that 20% are people that really didn't recognize that if you are going to run your own business, you have to be all in.
Yeah. And it usually takes longer than a year to really.
Yes. To establish.
Right.
Yeah. That first year, trust me, you are learning all kinds of lessons on what doesn't work.
Exactly. What not to do.
Yes. And like we were talking about before. I'd much rather learn that in person because I like to learn by doing
right
than sitting in a classroom.
Right. The first year is all learning, really.
Yeah.
And so it's a shame that many people quit that first year before they even really know what they're doing.
Right.
You know,
that's true. Well, I think it goes back to who you've surrounded yourself with.
Right.
Because if you have now, my father, bless his heart, loves me dearly. And sees how hard I have to work. And he remembers me, you know, going into my corporate job.
Right.
And not having, and then coming home. But he didn't see me come home exhausted.
Right.
And he didn't see how sad I was because I didn't let anybody know.
Right.
He didn't see that I was missing a piece of me.
Right.
And all he sees now is that I'm working 7 days a week, 16-hour days. And he can't help himself but say, I really wish you could go and get a regular job.
Right.
And that's out of love.
Mm-hmm.
So he gets a pass.
Right.
Plus he's my daddy.
Right.
And I'm his only girl. And, you know, so you might get that on occasion from some people. So you don't have to walk away from everybody. But if it's a constant repetitive thing.
Right.
Or my favorite one is, I told you so.
Mm.
You know, when you're having a challenge.
Right.
And you reach out to a friend and you might be venting
right.
or whatever. And they're like, well, I told you so. You just quit. Those kind of people you need to stay away
from. Yeah. Toxic relationships and business don't go well together.
No.
They don't mesh.
what I love about the At Work's opportunity too, and this is what something Gabby and four kids. How old are your kids?
I've got five total. Yeah. 19, 14, 13, 11, and 8.
Wow, that's a crew.
Yes, it is.
It's almost a baseball team.
Exactly. Four of them play baseball.
Oh, there you go. Well, and this opportunity gives you a lot more flexibility.
Absolutely. That is what I love the most is, you know, people, of course, always want to talk money.
Right.
But for me, the money gives you the freedom of time, which time is the most valuable thing.
Priceless.
We can always make more money. Yep. We can never get back time. So for me, back when I was working full-time bartending and working part-time for the doctor's organization, I was missing so much, so many baseball games, just so much, you know, events at school,
right?
Milestones, you know, when my little guy was, you know, just walking, I was already back in the bartending world. So right. I was just missing all those milestones. And for me, the time is the most valuable part of it, is that my husband and I, we wake up together every morning. We put the kids off to school together every morning. Then we decide what we're going to do with our day. Obviously, work is included, but, you know, right. sometimes we'll take a break and go on a day date, go for lunch. And then we get to meet back our kids after they get off school, figure out how our evening's going to look. That's every day. Every day is our Saturday. And I'm so, so grateful.
That's exciting.
Yeah.
I love that. As a mom, I love hearing things like that.
Because you only get one chance at it. You know, yeah. my kids, you know, my 19-year-old, I don't get to see her very much anymore. And I was in the work field when she was a kid. And so, you know, I can't take that back. But now even she loves it. She's like, Sterling, so lucky, my littlest guy, you know, you're always here. So it's amazing.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
So that gives it the freedom.
Yes, exactly.
Well, and if you think about how much moms with younger people have to pay daycare.
Right.
Oh,
crazy. Astronomical.
They almost have to have a job just to pay for it.
They got
to
have a second job usually just to pay for the daycare for the first job.
That's sad.
It's very sad.
Because you're missing your kids growing up.
Yeah. And you're barely, I've talked to people who honestly, their job covers the daycare basically.
Oh, no.
You know, and it's like, why? Why right. are you even doing that? For a little bit extra? You could be doing this from home for that little bit extra. Or you can make it something much bigger.
Just got to make the decision.
Exactly.
Got to be not afraid.
Right.
Don't be scared.
Right.
And that's easy to say.
It is.
Actually, there are days when I still have fears.
Absolutely.
Every day, actually.
Exactly. We all do.
Yeah.
But you grow through what you go through. And so every time you experience one of those challenges that your fears start to rise up and you get through it,
right.
the next time it's a little bit, just like you said, with public speaking, I was terrified of public speaking. And I had to start speaking at events for It Works and for my team and stuff. And now, yes, it's still not my favorite thing in the world.
Right.
But I can do it, you know. So you grow through what you go through, really.
I've progressed from that scared person at the school board meeting to the other day I spoke at Clearwater City Council meeting because I'm a resident. And I get 3 minutes, so I'm going to go speak about whatever I want.
Right.
And I get up there and, hey, y'all.
Yeah.
Like, yep, it's me.
Right.
And it's kind of funny because the last couple of times I've gone, apparently there's been a whole lot of neighbors that have been unhappy about something. So I'm the only happy person up there.
Oh.
I'm like, I didn't tell you what's happening at my store in Clearwater.
Right.
and then, you know, everybody talking behind me is like yelling at them. They're like, can we have Karina back?
I was going to say, you're inspiring other people.
They're complaining. I just want to build downtown Clearwater.
Right.
Back up.
Yeah.
And so that's why the Market Space for Good to me is it's an entrepreneur incubator.
Right.
And Gabby with It Works and we're going to brainstorm on having like a black and green party or It's Working party.
Absolutely.
Where people will be able to come out and meet the team
exactly.
and see if the opportunities for them too, right. or sample the products.
Yep.
So you're going to have to stay tuned for that one. Now we are live on the Shop Local for Good page. Do we have anybody on, Lorena, that has said hi yet?
Not on my end.
No, not on your end. Okay. Well, we want make sure you give a shout out to your small business or, I'm sure we have some of our At Work's team on there too. You could go ahead and drop your link in there.
Yeah.
Because we all have promotional codes. Now they're limited.
Yes, they are.
Yeah. So, and we are sharing. I love that Gabby was telling me that she's a rock star.
She is.
She's like, I'm running out of promo codes. I'm like, Lorena and I got your back.
Yeah, I got some too. We've got plenty to share. So,
yeah, they are generous with those kind of things.
Absolutely.
So I'm just really impressed after, it's been October that I started. I just really impressed with the culprit culture.
Yes.
To me, that's huge. I mean, the products are great. I could have been just stayed as a customer.
Right.
But I like to be involved and try to figure out ways where my company can help other entrepreneurs grow.
I love that.
And I love that. I love that It Works allows their distributors the flexibility with things like what Gabby's doing.
Absolutely.
The Saturday market every Saturday. Not only is she helping me manage the market, but she gets to showcase
her product.
Her product. Then the keto coffee fundraiser that we're doing for the Benevolution Foundation. By the way, that keto coffee is available at the Market Space for Good. Lorena will make you a cup of coffee and a dollar from each cup of coffee that you buy gets donated to the Benevolution Foundation.
I love that.
Which is our nonprofit incubator. And we currently have two nonprofits that we're assisting. One is Bailey's Way Rescue. They are a fostering rescue for dogs in the greater Tampa Bay area. And Kids Campaign. And their mission is dual mission. They like to encourage people to volunteer and get your friends and family to sponsor your volunteering by donating to Kids Campaign's second part of their mission, which is involved in pediatric cancer, helping families with pediatric cancer, because there's bills that come up with that. And there's just, it's so sad. There's a lot of bills that things don't cover, like travel expenses to go for treatment out of state, because sometimes there's not treatment here. And and they're, both of them are all volunteer nonprofits. So every dollar that gets donated to them it goes towards their mission.
Nice.
So with a little bit of overhead.
Yeah.
Because you got to pay for a website.
Right.
We talked about that.
Right.
So, and that's what I really appreciate you getting up so early and driving all the way here.
Absolutely. I appreciate you having me.
Coming in. And we'll definitely look forward to announcing the party in downtown Clearwater.
I'm excited.
With everybody. Now, we are Shop Local for Good News. You can go to our website. That's shoplocalforgoodnews.com. And we will also share Fair's team page so that you can connect with her team, my team, our team.
Our team.
And let's make it get working.
Let's do it.
It's working. And grow past your fears.
Awesome.
Practice being afraid. It's, you don't have to jump out of an airplane. Not that kind of fear.
No.
But do something that scares you a little bit every day, and it will get less and less. All right. This is Shop Local for Good News, Monday Motivation. Much thanks to Ed, our producer. And we will be on the air next Monday morning from 8 a.m. to 9. Have a great week, everybody.